What effect does attitude play in lower education in the United States? Does family interest in education affect the outcome? Why do rural students experience proportionally lower motivation in education than urban ones? Are the laws enacted to force targeted education effective? Can a mentor lead the way for young students to feel empowered in their own lives? And through mentoring, can we help the hidden student be more able to achieve positive motion in their educational life? The study, Impacts of No Child Left Behind on Curriculum and Instruction in Rural Schools by Andrea Freed, investigates how the No Child Left Behind Act has affected the school systems of Missouri and Maine, both states having more rural school districts than other states. No Child Left Behind Act mandates that schools make adequate yearly progress in reading and mathematics on state tests in order to continue to receive federal funding. The metric is applied to all students, regardless of their personal circumstance. 100% of all students in grade 3 through 8 must be proficient in math and science. The goal seems sound on its face, but can there be an abstract outcome from its implementation? The pressure on school administrators to show the needed performance is great. Thus, the program guidelines may be implemented in a cookie-cutter fashion that demeans the value of the education sought being delivered.
See, the sad thing about a guy like you is in 50 years, you're going to start doing some thinking on your own, and you're going to come up with the fact that there are two certainties in life. One, don't do that. And two, you dropped 150 grand on a fucking education you could have got for $1.50 in late charges at the public library.
50% of Maine teachers reported that the No Child Left Behind Act has had a large effect and is changing the way they teach. Teachers in Maine bemoaned a loss of flexibility to be creative that was replaced by a focus on reading, writing, and math.
You're a criminal because you robbed these kids of their creativity and their passion. That's the real crime.
Does this consistently difficult situation lead to parents, students, and educators to taking a position of less empowering interest in education?
Bueller.
Take this job and shove it. I ain't working here no more.
In Maine, many teachers in lower performing schools want to leave the profession and believe it is looking less attractive to new teachers. The potential number of experienced teachers leaving the profession as soon as they can get out and intelligent young people not entering the teaching profession means rural schools that already have difficulty finding highly qualified teachers may be heading for a future staffing disaster.
Is that all there is?
The study, reviewed by Stephen Gorad, Bing Hoot C., and Peter Davies, entitled Impact of Attitudes and Aspirations on Educational Attainment and Participation, examines whether the attitudes, aspirations, and behaviors of young people and their parents influence education attainment and participation.
I expected a little more from a varsity letterman.
In other words, the review is investigating any correlation between parental attitude and child motivation in approach to education.
This is it. This is all there is. You get a job, you make a living. You meet a girl, you get married, and you have kids. There's nothing else to it.
Pop, this can't be it. Right? I mean, what if I want to do something else?
Like what?
I don't know. Will you quit asking me?
The review found evidence of an association between parental expectations and their child's attainment, and three of the four causal criteria shown here were met, at least in part.
This is like a whole new school of child raising I'm doing. You give the kid options instead of orders, you know? Let him make the right decision.
You're a pioneer.
Thanks.
So you two just chill out together all day?
Basically. Went to the park yesterday, hung out on the monkey bars. The kid did 8 chin-ups.
8? I can't even do one with these scrawny arms.
They're not scrawny. They're nice.
Thanks.
So, Julian, what do you want to do tomorrow?
I want to go to school.
Look at that. I don't force him. He makes the right decision. Way to go, kid.
Aspiration, attitude, and behavior are clearly linked to an educational outcome. Children with higher expectations also have more success at school, and children who do worse at school have lower expectations.
This is Alex P. Keaton you're dealing with. I'm a member of the Interfraternity Council, and I go to a college where the students actually have brains.
The aspiration, attitude, or behavior that is supposed to cause the improvement in attainment or participation can be shown to have existed before it, and that it can be used to predict later attainment or participation. There are several mechanisms through which parents' expectations might conceivably affect children's attainment. They may devote more time and money to supporting their child's education. Second, parents' expectations might frame their children's expectations. Thirdly, parents' expectations may direct the way in which they respond to opportunities and problems their children encounter in school. Although young people from rich and poor families not only differ in how well they perform on exams, they also show marked differences in many family background characteristics, including parental education, family size, and ethnicity, and their attitudes and behaviors, and those of their parents, in the teen years. Epigenetics. According to the University of Utah's Genetic Research Center's webpage, embryos receive genetic transfer of attitudinal information at the time of development. Quotation: "We used to think that a new embryo's epigenome was completely erased and rebuilt from scratch, but this isn't completely true. Some epigenetic tags remain in place as genetic information passes from generation to generation, a process called epigenetic inheritance." Epigenetic inheritance is an unconventional finding. It goes against the idea that inheritance happens only through the DNA code that passes from parent to offspring. It means that a parent's experiences in the form of epigenetic tags can be passed down to future generations. End quotation. If those epigenetic tags are pre-programmed with success and motivation, the human embryo will have that influence in their life. Woo-hoo! But if the tags are programmed for lethargy and misdirection, so too will that path be taken. In both cases, though, the forming fetus receives the coding and carries that payload to be passed on to the following generation.
How was school?
Worst day of my life. What do you think?
You see, your actions have consequences.
The study, Impact in Attitudes and Aspirations on Educational Attainment and Participation, notes that there is no single area of change that can be affected in order to bring about an apathetic student.
What do you care what I think anyway? I don't even count, right? I could disappear forever and it wouldn't make any difference. I may as well not even exist at this school.
Students, school administrators, and parents are caught in a catch-22. No Child Left Behind Act requirements are putting stresses on school system administrators and the teachers. The parents are taking a hands-off approach to parenting and their students' education, and students lacking motivation for their own education. As in with association that was pointed out earlier, all of the interested parties are critical to the system's functioning, but each adds its own complexity to the problem. As well, the complexity continues to feed the energy of the Catch-22.
What has allowed some of our greatest leaders, some of our greatest influencers, to become who they are? He had a mentor. But they met this person at a young age.
Mentoring means talking. Mentoring focuses on the individual and the conversation transcends more broadly into the general educational life. This means the interaction can be more philosophical, more focused on attitudes and behaviors than on specific skills. Of course, these talks could also have the same level of focus and timelines, but the entire individual is the topic of discussion and exploration, and not just a specific task. Research has shown that actual experiences are the most effective learning tools. A mentor is someone who leads by example. They have seasoned experience to share and demonstrates integrity in their own life. Mentors are great listeners because they never miss an opportunity to learn something new. They are compassionate and understanding. Above all, mentors will take the time to get to know their mentee and how their relationship can help that person see a better version of themselves. Having a great mentor in a young person's life can make the difference between successfully taking on what feels like the ravages of life and living a life of constant struggle to find direction.
You have learned much, young one.
When a young student finds their own direction, they can truly begin to flourish for a lifetime.
Wanna let get in your heart, baby? Don't you forget about me. Don't you forget about me. Will you stand above me? Look my